In the first music transitions video, you were introduced to this transition rules system that allows us to define how transitions should occur as we move from one piece of music to another. In this video, we're going to explore more options for how we can make those transitions as smooth as possible. In the Cube demo game, when transitioning from the Explorer to the combat music, the player needs to hear a fairly fast transition in order to match the intensity of the gameplay as the monsters attack. To ensure a fast transition, let's set up a rule for Explorer to combat, and set the exit source at property to next beat. We'll add a new transition rule, and we'll start with Explorer as the source, and combat as the destination. And change our exit source at property to next beat. Let's take a listen. Currently, the player is in the explore mode. And let's switch to combat. The change feels a bit awkward. The reason is because when we jump to the destination, it's playing the combat music from the entry cue at the beginning of the music segment, which is usually the first beat of a bar. This sounds odd because we're likely to be exiting the explore music at a beat in the middle of a bar. This can leave the rhythmic impression that we had a bar of odd meter. The other problem is the explore and combat music are based on the same chord progression, but jumping unexpectedly to a different part of the chord progression also feels strange. To handle this, in the destination area, we'll change the sync to property to say same time as playing segment. This way, if you leave the source at measure 2 beat 3, it will transition to the destination at measure 2 beat 3. This assumes that the tempo of the music segments are the same, which is the case. Now let's take a listen. Let's go back and start with explore music. And now we'll transition to combat. Because the chord progressions are the same in both pieces of music, both the rhythm and the harmonic structure stays intact, and the transition feels more musical. The transition from explore to combat still feels a bit abrupt. This is because there's an instant switch to the combat music. To smooth this out, we need a bit of a crossfade, allowing the sound of the source to fade out while the destination fades in. In the source area, click the Fade Out checkbox. For this to have an effect, we need to edit the fade properties. Click the Edit button. For the time property, enter a value of 1 second. A graphic representation shows that the sound will begin to fade out a second before reaching its exit point, which in this case will be on the next beat. This will sound a bit odd. We really want the beat that occurs at the transition point to be heard. To account for this, enter an offset of 1 second. And we can see that the fade will occur during the second after the beat plays, allowing the attack of the beat to be heard. We can adjust the fade's curve to our liking as well. We need something similar for when the destination music fades in. Click the Fade In checkbox. Click Edit. And set the fade time to 1 second. Here we can see that the first beat of the music won't clearly be heard because it's still fading in. Set the offset to negative 1 second, and we'll choose the same type of curve. Let's take a listen. Go back to explore music, and now we'll hear the transition to combat. Now the transition feels much smoother. A concern when transitioning between the explore and the combat music is that both types of music have a special bridge section that occasionally plays at semi-random times as defined by their music playlist containers. These bridge sections have a different chord structure than the main parts of those themes. Let's take a listen. Here's the explore bridge. and the Combat Bridge. So if the explore music was in a bridge and we transition to the next beat to the combat music, and the combat music selects something other than its bridge, then the musical chord structure won't sound correct. To prevent this from happening, we need to add these objects into the transition system. So we'll go back and select the Wwise-201 music switch container, and then create a new transition rule. The rule should say that if the explore bridge is playing, and we're transitioning to the combat music, then what's going to happen? As before, we'll set the exit source app property to next beat, and we'll set the sync to property to same time as playing segment. But this time, we'll also use this jump to feature. This allows us to choose the specific part of the destination's playlist we want to go to under this particular circumstance. We'll change the setting to specific playlist item. Click the Browse button, and we can see the entire configuration of the Combat Music's playlist. You can expand its hierarchy, and we can see the Combat Bridge. Select that, and now it's guaranteed that if the Explore Bridge music is playing, when the player goes into combat mode, the music will always transition to the Combat's Bridge music. In some situations, it's difficult to transition between differing types of music without having a customized transitional piece of music as an interlude. In Cube, there's a storyline part of the game that has special music that has a unique feel. Let's take a listen. We'll collapse the combat and explore music, and we'll expand the story music playlist container. And here's the main musical cue for the story segment. In this case, the composer felt that when going from the explore music to the story music, an added musical cue was necessary. Let's take a listen. To use this, we'll add another transition rule, so we'll go back and select the Wwise-201 music switch container, add our new transition, and in this case, we want to come from explore to story. Set exit at source to next bar. And then we'll go to the transition segment area. Here we'll click the Use Transition Segment checkbox. Then we'll click the Browser button. Expand it. And then choose Trans to Story. And then click OK. Now let's test it. We want to have our music in the Explore mode, and then come from the Gameplay mode, and we'll make sure our music state is set to Gameplay. Here's the Explore music. And now let's switch to the storyline. There's the transition piece. Followed by the main story music. As we've worked, we've been building up a list of transition rules. It's possible that multiple rules could apply to a given circumstance. For example, when moving from the Explore Bridge music to the Combat music, the Any to Any, Explore to Combat, or Explore Bridge to Combat all apply. Which rule takes priority is based on where it appears in the list. Transitions at the top of the list have lower priority, or you could say the items at the bottom of the list take highest priority. It's possible to move transition rules in the list. For example, if I move the Explore Bridge to Combat rule higher on the list, the Explore to Combat rule would override the more specific circumstance of what should happen when the Explore Bridge music is playing and the player goes into combat. For this reason, the easiest way to think of it is that more general rules should be on top. This is why the default Any to Any rule is the one rule that cannot be moved from the very top, and more specific circumstantial rules should be moved towards the bottom of the list. This is why we want the Explore Bridge to Combat rule down at the very bottom. For complex music systems, you could have hundreds of transition rules, so to make them easier to move in bulk, you can create a group and add rules into the group. Just as a quick example, let's do that with the Explore Music rules. We'll click the Add Group button, and then we can take all of the Explore rules and move them into that group. You can then easily move a group and expand groups to see their content. In this case, this is not what we want to do, so I'm going to undo this. But as you can see, the transition system offers a solution for almost any situation that could arise as you integrate music into your game.